Guys, this is Sandeep here from London. Welcome to my channel. In today's video, I will be taking you through BMC Remedy ER server. So in this particular video, we will see what exactly is ER server, what are different processes in ER server, how we can troubleshoot some issues with the ER server. So just a basic overview of ER server. So let's start. Now, you know, when we install BMC Remedy on, you know, any environment, whether it's a Linux, it's Solaris or Windows. So this AR server is installed as a service on BMC Remedy. So on Windows, because I have Windows environment, but in Linux and Solaris, it will also be the same. Like the other services, it will run, it will be a running service. So in Windows, the AR server process is like this. So you will be able to find it with this name,
which is AR server process, which
basically when you install it, you will see this process here in the you will see this service here for AR server. Now you will have some additional services also, which is this BMC Remedy email engine. So this is for email engine. Then you will have one for flashboard server. And then, you know, with the, if you have the latest version of BMC Remedy, you will have also this service. Like if you have installed mid-tier here, this is mid-tier file deployer service. So it helps us in deploying the patches on the server. So let's go back to the AR server. So this is the server you will service you will see for AR server. Now if I go to my task manager and if I want to see the, you know, details of these processes which are running, so by default you will see these, you know, number of processes running on your system. So this one is the first one, AR email ID. It, like with the name itself, it explains this is for email server. This is for flashboard, the second one, AR FLSD. Then AR monitor.exe. This is for the monitor file. This I will explain you what exactly this is. We will take this with the monitor file. We'll understand this later. Then we have this AR plugin and AR dispatcher. This is the command dispatcher service. And then this AR plugin is for all the plugins which are there in the AR system. So the responsibility of this particular service or this particular process is to execute all the plugins which are there in the AR server. Okay, so these are the some common you know, services running. But if you have some other components installed, then you will have some other services, like you will have recon services for CMDB. Similarly, you will have service for SLM if you have those components installed. But in my system, I don't have those components, so I have only these number of services now. Okay, so where the AR server is installed, let me minimize this. Okay, when you install it, it will ask you for a location, but by default, normally we always put it in the C drive. But ideally, it is not a good practice. If you want to install AR server, you have to designate a location which is not a system drive. So normally C is our system drive. So we should put it in some D or any other folder so that it will segregate it from the system files. But here I have installed it in the C drive. So we will go here in the program files. There we need to go to BMC software, AR system, and then here I need to go to AR server and then DB. So here, this is the place where all the logs, basically the server logs or the logs which are enabled on server, get captured here. So by default, it has a one you know, file which is called AR error. So if I open this file, so this basically is a file which captures all the errors happening on the AR server. So when you restart a service or if there are any errors coming from any workflow, all is captured here in this file. For example, if I take you to the bottom of this file, so, and just let's have a little explanation about this one. So here you can see it will give you details about AR server, like AR server started, then assignment engine, then there's some other configurations, then flashboard server is not currently up, maybe it was brought down. Then okay, so this AR server will basically, this file or the log file will show us all the, you know, operations which are happening on AR server, whether you are getting some errors, you are getting some issues. So it will be captured here. Mostly the issues related to AR server, it will not capture all the workflow errors. Sometimes there will be some, you know, major issues which are like caused due to the workflows, that will be captured here. So if I go back here to the bottom, so you can say there were some errors captured, like entry does not exist in the database. These are all like when you are searching for a record which is not there, so you got this error and it has come because of the some REST call. So if we have done a REST call or a REST API call to AR server and then there was this error, it is captured here. Similarly, there are some authentication failure errors which are captured in this log. So this, if you have to debug or troubleshoot AR server, you can take a reference of this AR error log. Now, okay, apart from this also, there are multiple other logs, and like you will have a log for plugin. We will have a log in for Java plugin. If you open it, it will have, you know, errors related to the plugin server. So in case you want to debug your plugin server, you can basically check this log and see if there are any errors from the plugin. Then folder will also contain the logs which are enabled on the server side. So if you enable any logs on the server side, or you have to debug or troubleshoot, you can enable them on the server side, and then those logs will be captured here. They will come here in this directory, and then you can check or debug your operations. Now similarly, it will have logs for the approval server. So all the operations happening on approval server, if you want to debug, it will be here. So in short, it contains all the major, you know, operation logs which are happening on the AR server. So this is it will basically have those also, and the ones when you enable them. Now we'll see a very important thing here regarding the AR monitor file. Now let me go back. So before going to AR monitor file, let's see one more important thing, which is this configuration file. So if I go to AR server, then I will go in this conf folder. So it will have this file called AR.cfg. So this AR.cfg basically is the configuration of the AR server. So if I open it here in the notepad, let me drag this. Okay, so here you will be able to see the configuration of your AR server, like what is the server name, the configuration name, then the directory where the server is installed, then the other things like whether it's a, you know, multiple AR servers are installed, with single server is registered with port mapper, what is the TCP port, plugin port, database details, like this one. So then other, you know, server operations, like whether the unqualified search is enabled or not, then the SLM collector, you know, these are all operations or the options available on the server administration form. So whatever changes you do that in that form comes here. So if I go to the server administration form, let me show you server administration form. Let me log in here and I will show you the server administration form. So if I go here from AR system administration console, then system general and server information. This is basically the form which records all the the administrative configuration of a server, and then same gets recorded here in this particular form. So whatever changes you do there or here will be reflected once you restart the services. So here you can see this configuration. hello guest users, hello uncle. So these are the different operations. If I make, suppose, disable admin operations, apply, then it will make changes in that my config file. So, but I can also make changes directly in the config file and restart the services. It will be reflected here. But the recommended way of making the changes is here itself. There are some operations where we do it in the KR config file. This will take it with some other videos. So now currently let's go back to the conf folder. So now in the conf folder, we have also this one, which is armonitor.cfg. Let me open this. So this armonitor.cfg basically contains all the processes which are running here. If I go here in the task manager, so you can see there are these number of processes which are running. These all processes are defined in this armonitor.cfg. So if you want to disable any process, for example, you have to disable the recon process for CMDB, or you have to disable the recon process, sorry, SLM collector process. So you can hash it out in this particular file. So you can take a backup of this file, then put a hash like this, and then you can restart the services. So it will only take when the AR server starts, it reads the all the processes from this particular file, and all processes or all services which are enabled will be started, or they will be executed. The rest will not be touched. Similarly, when you know the AR services, AR server services, suppose we go back to task manager, suppose they have also AR server service goes down, AR plugin service goes down, or AR email engine goes down due to some unavoidable circumstances or some issues, this AR monitor file will automatically pick it and will restart it. So you don't need to start it manually, it will be automatically picked. So this is basically a monitoring process, and this is the configuration for monitoring. So it will check if any of the processes which are mandatory for AR server, if they go down, then it will basically take it again, it will restart it or bring it up for the users to use. So this is the role of AR monitor file and AR monitor process. In Windows, it gets installed in the same conf directory, but in Linux, normally it gets installed in the system directory, which is etc var something. So it goes there, and then the process is same, the services configuration, everything is same, except of some the folder locations. Rest all things are same. So these are the key aspects of AR server, or just an overview of how AR server works, or in case of some minor troubleshooting, how you can do it with the AR server logs. Thank you.